people.
There's two types of people in this world. Have you guys ever heard anybody say that? There's two types of people in this world. There's winners and there's losers. Wow. Let's get a nice surprise on. I'm not a loser, I'm a winner. Yeah. Another example. There's two types of people in this world. There's those that see the glass half full, and there's those that see the glass half empty. Optimists and pessimists. But sometimes people use this too much, in my opinion. There's two types of people in this world. There's dog people, and there's cat people. I'm like, really? I mean, I know some cat people that like dogs. That's taking a little bit too far for me. But today I want to talk about a different two types of people. These two types of people are those who say that life is short, and those people who say that life is long. So, quick survey. Who here is one of those people that says life is short? If you say life is long. And if you're too shy to vote or it takes you a really long time to make a decision, anybody here? I just need that for the accuracy of the survey. Thank you so much. And I'm glad there's a lot of people here that think life is short, because I'm going to call you life is short people. And I love life is short people. Whenever I'm at a party, I always want to hang out with the life is short person because they're fun. I also like them because they say things like, live every day as if it was your last day. So life is short people, you've probably said that before, right? And what did you do today? Went to work, probably, and then you came here. Whew. Well, my last day, I mean, myself, I prefer to do skydiving, bungee jumping, I don't know. I would never do those things now because I'm not crazy, but on my last day, yes, I would like to do these things. So anyway, so you went to work today, made a little bit of money, right? With that money, probably you buy some food, you buy some rent, maybe even pay a little bit of your mortgage. Which, by the way, makes no sense if you have a mortgage and you think the life is short. Who has mortgages? Life is long people. Life is long people also have insurance. Oh my God, life is long people are so boring. They also say that life is like a marathon. It's like, I'm just gonna keep steady pace, da 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 da. Now life is short people say life is like a sprint. It's like I'm born, boom, let's go. And because I am who I am and I always overanalyze things, I was thinking about this. Is life like a marathon or is life like a sprint? And then I was thinking, well, actually a personal trainer would tell you the best way is actually to do circuit training, a mix of sprint and marathon, right? It's basically you do a sprint, you take a break, and then you do another sprint. And so I was thinking about this as an analogy for our life. It has some potential. Thinking about my life, normally in my day I start my morning with a sprint, so it's not exercise, I just go to work. Now, it's not because I love it, I have to work, I don't have another choice, but I figured that because I'm there I might as well do the best job I can, I might as well work hard, right? So this morning is my sprint, midday you have lunch, take a break, relax, recuperate a little bit, then go to the afternoon, you have your second sprint, right? And then the challenge is always to adjust from work Chris to home Chris, to get this part of my mind gone and then go home and spend time with the family. And that last part of the time with the family is that last sprint, right? And on the weekends, different, better, so it might be actual exercise, it might be going to movie, time with friends, these types of things. So these are the types of sprints that you have on the weekend. Now, where we run into problems, where we run into trouble, is with what I call zombie time. So you know the Walking Dead? Zombie time, it's like, we're at work, but we're not really working. Or we're at home, and you got your wife here and your kid here, and you're staring at the TV, you're not even looking at them or talking to them or anything. And I'm not trying to say, don't check your Facebook at work and don't watch TV. Yeah, of course, that's human nature at this point, I do it too. But all I'm trying to say is do these things as a break to recuperate from your sprint. And then when you get your energy back, then go back and do another sprint. When we do these things instead of our sprint is when it becomes to be a little bit problematic. Now, if you want to make this nice and simple, life is short when we're having fun. Or life is short, or at least when we're engaged in something, right? So we could be fixing the house, reading a book. That's when it seems like life is short for us. But I have a question. Can you have too much fun? They say no. Okay, no. On Friday night, I can go home, share a bottle of wine with my wife. That's a good time, right? Now, if I go home every single night and drink a entire bottle of wine by myself, wake up with a hangover every single day, I probably had too much fun. What's the best example? The best example is sex. Sex is fun, right? It should be fun. I hope it's fun for you guys. Can you have too much of it? Oh, yeah. And get sexual diseases, or if you're paying child support to three different women, sex becomes too much fun, right? So you can have too much fun. So we come back to the circuit training approach, where you start your day with a sprint, you take a break, then when you recover, then you do another sprint. Find that unhappiness often comes from either too much fun or a lack of engagement. So I asked you guys at the beginning, do you believe that life is short, or do you believe that life is long? Well, if you ask me, I'll tell you that life is long. But if you live your life this way, breaking it into segments and parts, and live those parts like life is short, you'll never even realize just how long life can be.